Remix. This week is Love Makes the World Go Round.
But laughter keeps us from getting dizzy.
Oh, gosh. In 5, 4, 3, 2.
The Mooresville Winter Ensembles will be hosting a Winter Guard Indoor Percussion and Winds competition next Saturday, February 22nd, here at MHS.
The competition will be held at 9 a.m. in the main gym.
Our team's performance times are
Mooresville Middle School,
9:20 a.m.,
JV Guard,
12:05 p.m.,
Varsity Guard,
3:47 p.m.,
Percussions,
7:54 p.m.,
and Winds,
8:50 p.m. Tickets are $10 for ages 13 and up. More info can be found online at this website.
Registration for the following school year is coming up.
You need to start thinking about what elective courses you want to sign up for.
Now, let's take a look at some of the electives that are available at MHS.
I took it for all 4 years and I really have enjoyed it and I do recommend it. It's a good place where you can be able to grow leadership and character and also self-discipline. And also you do a lot of fun events with other people. And as an NS4, you also have a big chance to be able to lead and just have a lot of fun with the events and be able to be part of a big family.
I took AP Stat. It's a great class because while it's a little difficult, you have a great support system and it's really nice.
I took AP Bio. If you like science classes, it's a really good class for you to take.
I took AP Psychology because I'm interested in majoring in psychology in college. And it's a really good class because you learn more about the way the brain works and behaviors as well as emotions.
I have taken Sculpture 2. I think people should take the class because, you know, like when you're a kid and you really want to like make something but you can't because you don't have the materials. In this class you basically have the materials to do that and you can make what you want to make.
And in automotive we learned the basic fundamentals.
And then we also learned basic maintenance of keeping your vehicle maintained. This also goes from anywhere from just getting regular oil changes or taking care of your brakes and everything that goes along with that.
You should take AP European History because I guarantee it will be the most interesting class you take in high school, and you get to learn all about European art, innovation, social movements, and more.
Don't miss the $5 off yearbook special for leap year.
Go to yearbookforever.com now through the end of February and use code LEAP to get $5 off your next purchase.
It is time to check out other things that have been happening around campus.
So we made cards, postcards, and on the front of them we drew a famous painting from an American artist and we sent them to Holland as part of an art exchange. On the back it has information all about the artist and a little bit about America.
We each got assigned a group and it was the different empire and each part of the body represented a different part of the society and we had to list facts about all the parts of society and then we glued them down and we painted a picture of what they would wear in their ancient time period.
So basically what we're doing in AP Gov today is we are having a debate slash discussion with another AP Gov class in Pennsylvania and we're talking about just like politics and like just like the states versus like the federal government.
we're just fishing. I say daddy loves you, baby, one more time. She says I know, I think I've got a bite.
Thanks for fishing with us. Well done on your home waters.
My music video is for Galley Man Project in Foods class.
When you drink your school milk carton, if you can drink the milk.
It was about the gallon unit and those well.
Me and my group, we made a music video for the gallon man's group.
But yeah, we had a lot of fun doing it, you know. Once you stop having fun with it, you're done with it, you know what I'm saying? So
I teach a course called CTE Internship. And what CTE Internship is about is gaining class credit while also gaining work experience that you can add to your resume for obtaining a job in the future. It also looks good on college applications as well.
I currently am interning at Parkview Elementary, where I work with the kindergartners. I really enjoy getting to act as a teacher assistant in that classroom, and it really helps me decide if I want to major in early childhood education in college.
The Junior Civitans are hosting a coin drive going on now through the 24th.
The coin drive is to raise money for the organization Food for Days.
The third block with the most money raised will be getting a pizza party.
Career and College Promise applications for next school year are due to Ms. Justice in room B227 by today.
Want to get involved? Let's get plugged in.
Let's see what's going on.
Hi, my name is Molly, and I'm playing the Sweethearts Dance, and it is Saturday from 7 to 10, and all the proceeds are being donated to the American Heart Association and Time Out Youth, so please come out and support a semi-formal event. So, yeah.
Hi, I'm Savannah Amick. I am the president of National Technical Honor Society. As a club, we allow students to get recognition for their CTE classes. A couple qualifications that we require for students who plan on taking this as a club is that you have a 3.0 overall GPA, have no disciplinary issues or attendance issues here at the high school, and that we require you to have a teacher recommendation. You can contact Ms. Fowler at sandyfowler@mtsc.k12.nc.us. And these applications are due February 15th, so come join.
And we're with Environmental Club. We're currently running a bottle cap drive because, in case you didn't know, bottle caps are not recyclable. If you put a bottle, a water bottle, in the recycling with a bottle cap on it, they will throw it away. So what we're doing is we are going to recycle these bottle caps and create a mural to put in the Magnolia Courtyard. So these bottle caps will be, bottle cap boxes will be in some teacher rooms, and they'll also be in the cafeteria as well as teacher workrooms. So if you guys have a water bottle and you're recycling it, make sure to take off the bottle cap and put it in one of our boxes. Thanks.
Hey, what's up, Mooresville? I'm here at Red Scratch Made Bake Shop. If you're looking for something to do, come here.
Let's go.
Come here tomorrow on Valentine's Day and get the specialty box. Strawberry truffle, triple chocolate Nutella, and peanut butter honey. The flavors change every week, and if there are any changes, they're posted on their Instagram.
Advisor here at MHS. This is particularly for the juniors. I know I sound like a broken record, but the ACT is coming up on February 25th. The ACT is such a good opportunity because any other time that you go to take the SAT or the ACT, you have to take it on a Saturday morning and you have to pay for it. So this is the only time that you get to take it during the school day. The school already registered you for it and you have to be here anyway. I would really recommend prepping for it. It's going to set you up really well for applying to colleges next year. If you're thinking about going to a four-year, think about two-year, you need it for your placement tests, and it will save you time and stress in the long run.
Do you need to file taxes this year? Well, if your earned income was $12,200 this year, or your unearned income was $1,500 this year, then you probably should.
So what do you need to file? So you need your W-2, which your employer should give you. They're supposed to mail them out by January 31st of each year. And you need to go to the IRS.gov site, and you can complete a Form 1040.
If you're having a bad day, the only advice I can give you is to smile. There's always a reason to smile. You're having a bad day, your friend's having a bad day, try to put a smile on the face.
What makes you smile?
Because I had the best ways in the school.
Your segment on BDU.
Your background on your phone?
On February 20th, you are invited to hear Dr. Brandon Winford, Associate Professor of History at the University of Tennessee.
He will be hosting a community meeting at 6:30 p.m. in the Performing Arts Center.
Dr. Winford is a graduate of MHS and is coming to discuss his newest book and research of the Civil Rights Movement.
He will also be sharing his experiences of growing up as an African American in Morrisville and how it has impacted his life.
This event is free and open to all community members.
And now it's time to get to know some of your fellow Blue Devils.
So what is your position here at Morrisville High School?
I'm junior English teacher, also teach the class sports and literature, and I'm assistant girls basketball coach for Coach Clark.
And I also heard that you host Cornhole for Cancer. Can you tell us something about
that? Yes, Sports and Lit hosts Cornhole for Cancer every year. In fact, we've already raised close to $3,000 this year in shirt sales and with sponsors. The tournament will be May 8th at Joe Pop Stadium. We're hoping to set a new record of over $4,000 this year. We've done something for cancer causes and other causes since 2005.
All right, y'all, we're going to honor our February Teacher of the Month, so let's go and surprise them.
Let's go.
I think they're taking a test.
All right, everybody, I need your attention. Can we pause this?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
We're here to celebrate our February Teacher of the Month. Get over here. Mr. Simpson, let's give it up.
Simpson, man. I'm very proud of him. He does really good teaching.
My name is Brody Biggs, and this is the Artist Spotlight. I've been drawing for about 2 years now. I've really got into it. This is a drawing I did about 4 months ago. It took about 3 days. It's Woody and Buzz looking into the horizon.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's the Student Spotlight!
It's the Student Spotlight, and today we're joined by Adir Abdullah. So we heard that you're a part of this Diversity Ambassadors event. Could you tell us a little bit more about what happened the other day?
All right, so I am the president of the Student Diversity Ambassadors, which is basically an organization trying to spread awareness and acceptance of the different diversity groups we have here at Morrisville High School. So the other day we had a Tough Talk, which is where we come together, we invite the school improvement team, parents, and our peers, of course, and we talk about the different conversations, the difficult conversations of what it's like to be a minority here and how we can improve that and make sure that everyone's loved and accepted for who they are.
Well, that sounds so great. Is there anything coming up that we can look forward to?
Yes, so February 20th, we are having an event with a guest speaker, hopefully the STEP team, and we are going to have theater involved as well. You should come check it out and celebrate Black History Month with us.
Sounds like a fun time. People, you better be there or be square. This has been the Student Spotlight. Adira was great. That'll be it. See you next time.
For the next few episodes of Baca Clock, we will be taking a detour from how we usually do it, and we'll be making a multi-parter. Mr. Bach is helping me with my capstone. We'll be creating a light bulb and an effective battery. Stay tuned next time where we'll try to be creating a working prototype.
Friday the 13th, the non-gamers conversation.
Stone Street.
Howdy, sweetheart. Back in 1929, two gangs got into it in Chicago. Al Capone, the famous mafia boss, set a trap for Bugs Moran, what was called the St. Valentine's Day Massacre. Two policemen dressed up and shot Bugs Moran's men, but they missed Bugs Moran. Later, Al Capone would go to prison for tax evasion.
If you are 30 minutes late to school, you need to come to the front office, make sure that you do a check-in on the computer here, and always try to bring a note with you for a reason why you were late to school. All right? And try not to do it again.
Outdoor track will be starting on February 24th. You must have a physical on file in order to participate.
Sign up for the remind by texting the message at MHS Tracka to the number 81010. Or see Coach Clark, Croakman, Greg, Landis, or Burks if you have any questions.
Now, let's dribble on to Trevor and get into the sports.
What it do, Big Blue? It's the boy Trent McCow, a.k.a. T-Bone. And we out here with Zy Ramsey of the Mooresville basketball team. Zy was a close game. He took him out overtime. Started off kind of shaky. How did you guys stay positive and keep competing in this game?
We know we the underdog coming in. We know we got to keep fighting through anything. Everything don't go our way. So we know we just got to keep fighting.
Zy, you've dunked several times this year. You got bunnies this year. Would you dunk on Sling?
Of course. But I ain't gonna do it to him.
That's what we got for you this week. Next week, spring sports start. What happens in the spring?
Football, baby.
Baseball.
Chinese cities are forcing coronavirus patients to come forward by restricting cough medicine sales. At least three Chinese cities have restricted the sales of over-the-counter cough and fever medications.
I'm slumped.
In a slump.
Oh, like I'm slumped? I'm puzzled.
I'm tired.
I'm in the bad mood.
I'm slumped. I'm tired.
Is it this? I'm slumped back.
I'm very tired.
It means that I'm in a low place in my life.
When I'm slumped, I'm stuck in a hole.
Tired, lazy.
This week is National Love the Bus Week.
We thank all of our bus drivers for everything they do to keep us safe.
Tomorrow's Valentine's Day. Do you have a Valentine?
I sadly do not.
One of you out there need to buy this man some chocolate or some flowers or something tomorrow. Be his Valentine.
You know what?
Till next time.
We'll see you.
Who's your Valentine? My beautiful girlfriend, Kaylee Redia. Who's your Valentine?
My Valentine is Schwartz and his bald head.
Man, who's your Valentine?
Jacob Jordan.
Who's your Valentine? Cooper Stissel. Who's your Valentine?
God.
Who's your Valentine?
My boo, Alyssa Watson.
So I want to shout out Miss K. She's my Valentine. I love you, Miss K.
Who's your Valentine?
Valerie.
Who's your Valentine?
My wonderful husband, Brian.